I think it's just wonderful having females at the epicenter of these fantastic horror films. I mean, and you know, there's been so often that women were used as bait in these horror movies, or used as, like, you know, some sort of gratuitous relief for the male audience, and now they're here and they're taking control and they're at the epicenter of all of it, and it's just a wonderful thing to see. I mean, there's themes of taking control of one's own body. There's themes, I mean, obviously deep religious themes in this film. There's themes of feminism and, yeah, I mean, there's a lot. There's a lot. Give me 5 minutes and I'll come up with a few more. There's loads of little moments of symbolism in the movie that kind of echo the beginning. The opening scene is also an homage to the first movie. All of our fantastical deaths and crazy, you know, violent moments are all very much thematically a nod to the original. So it's a lot of fun. Like Easter eggs, you're going to find them. That's the way horror films should be enjoyed and experienced, is with a bunch of people who are equally and mutually terrified with you. I mean, it's the best thing.
It feels really good. I've just got off the plane. I'm a little bleary, but it's summertime here, and it's great. I love making the movie. We made it in Rome. I love Nell Tiger Free. She's just sensational. She's my new favorite thing, and we had a great time, and I'm looking forward to seeing her, and everybody is excited. Good versus evil. I mean, it's pretty simple, and I can't tell you too much without spoiling it for you in terms of the major theme. But yeah, really, it's just designed precisely. Someone who saw it in London said, quote, "I was traumatized." Well, that's pretty much what we're shooting for. So if you want to get traumatized, it's not so much about the themes, it's more about the trauma, being stunned by horror. The people that like to make an appointment with fear actually pay money to get, you know, scared. It's what better than to do it with a lot of other people? Because then, you know, then it's like frightened squared. You know what I mean? Then it's a collective howl of horror.
All I can say is that I worked with amazing people, creative people that have done an amazing job. I think it's art, and art speaks for itself. I think, my opinion, it's an important movie, especially now. It's more of a psychological sort of film than a horror. That's my opinion. It's scary nonetheless.
Amazing. I'm really happy to be here and really excited as well. And yeah, I can't wait to see all the cast members, all the people, and get to watch the movie. So amazing. I'm really happy to be here. I don't think we would have the movie we have without Arkasha directing it. She just has this special vision, special sensibility that adds everything to the story. I mean, it's the best place to enjoy a movie. And of course, you see, when it's a horror movie, it's just so much better to share it with other people. So I really encourage everyone to go see it in theaters. I mean, there's new characters like mine. but of course, I feel like we give the original film so much more further context. And also, I feel like we answer to some questions that may rise when you watch The Omen. And I just hope people go to watch The Omen, my generation, that probably doesn't know it, after they watch our movie as well.
It's so exciting. I mean, this is my first one of these. So yeah, it's very overwhelming. I'm from New Zealand, and being here in LA is like wild. I think we just lean very much into celebrating women, but also the fears that we have as women and what it is like to be a woman. So yeah, it's a strong female crew. So we definitely talk a lot about women, body autonomy, conspiracy. There's a lot interwoven in. It's more than just your kind of jump scary horror film, as you'll see. I mean, horror is the best. I feel like the energy and the atmosphere and just being with so many people, it's what makes it. So it's very exciting.
Yeah, so I think a lot about this movie is about repressed intuition and trauma and how that resurfaces. I think that it's, you know, a lot of this is kind of similar to Repulsion, in the sense that it's a woman coming undone and trying to differentiate between what's real and what's not real, what's trauma and what's not. And what's
yeah, it's a film that centers on birth, so it really is all entirely kind of centered on the female body and our main character Margaret's experience going through this journey. So
we got some pretty big swings, I feel like, in this movie, and it's really nice to have the communal experience when you discover those scenes and those shots.
Yeah, once it gets going, it's pretty crazy. So yeah, it's definitely meant to be enjoyed in the theater.
It was really exciting once you got past the nerves, because there was so much room given to us to create another world. And I think also because we're so reverent to the original, we didn't want to recreate that.
So. Yeah, it's incredibly exciting to contribute to the legacy of the Omen. It's a historic franchise. It's one of our favorites. So to be a part of that history is so special.
Well, the point of this movie was to hopefully answer a few questions. But then for me, as an Omen fan myself, it seemed to open a whole new box of questions. So it's just continues to be an exciting exploration into the Omen franchise, I feel like.
Yeah. I think everyone wonders how Damien was born, like I said. And anybody who's familiar with the original, there's all kinds of homages and throwbacks. So it should be a lot of fun.
Incredible. I'm so very excited. This is an idea that I had a while ago, took it to the studio, and thankfully they loved it and championed it. David Goyer, the producer, shepherded it all the way through, and Keith, Tim, and Arkasha brought it home in the most brilliant way. I was just absolutely blown away by how they finished it, and I think it's a movie that we're all incredibly proud of. The struggle between good and evil. There is something inherent, I think, in all of us, where we want to be good, we want to believe that the world is all good, but we start opening some doors and we start questioning, oh, are there malefactors behind some of those doors? What is the truth behind the gears of society and behind institutions like, say, the Catholic Church, which is what we explore here? We set it in the 70s in Rome, leading up to the events of the very first Omen, and that's the biggest honor, I think, that we could have had, was telling that story leading up to the first events of the movie, the original movie. So that's a big nod. Oh God, that's what it's all about. It is the shared thrill of not knowing what's going to happen next. And we are going for the real classic 1970s supernatural psychological horror movies. And there's nothing like sitting with hundreds of people in a movie theater watching the screen and nobody knows what's about to happen. It's thrilling.
Terrifying, obviously. Yeah, Patrick Troughton, such an iconic performance. And the part was also played by Pete Postlethwaite in the remake in 2006. He's a big acting hero of mine. So yeah, it was a double whammy, really, of intimidating actors to take their role. It's a lot about body autonomy, women, and about the power of fear and the power of belief, I think, and what that can twist the human mind to accept and believe. Yeah, I think everybody understands the aesthetic, the world of the Catholic Church and God, the devil. The aesthetic of it is just so universal, really, now. And so, yeah, everybody's kind of scared and freaked out by that. So to see it all together in a theater is the way to watch a movie like this, definitely.
Very exciting. It's been a long road to get here, so looking forward to showing the movie to audiences for the first time and having people, you know, jump out of their seats. There's a lot of different stuff. Obviously, institutional power, you know, control of women's bodies, just, you know, faith and how it can pervert and can corrupt, and, you know, there's a lot of other stuff as well. But I think those are the three that, you know, probably work their way to the forefront the most. Well, obviously, we have a big tie-in towards the end of the film, which I'm sure audiences can guess. But we also have some characters, you know, that flow through our film into the original. We have Father Brennan, played by Ralph Ineson in our film, and Patrick Troughton in the original. We have a character, Father Spoleto, who goes on to be in the original film. We have a couple, you know, fun callbacks to some of the carnage and mayhem that happens in the original film. So I think for fans of the original, they're going to get a ton. And I think also for people who haven't seen it, you know, I think when they make their way to the original, they're going to realize some of the stuff that, you know, that we've homaged to, and but also put our own spin on it. Yeah, well, you know, I mean, there's some big moments of, I think, boundary pushing shock and awe. That I think just don't hit the same when you're at home on your couch. So, you know, when you're in a packed theater on a Friday night, you get to feel, I think, the electricity that comes through the crowd. And I think we definitely have those moments that feed the crowd.